Hello, Exoplaneteers. So the other day, a buddy of mine calls me and he says, "Hey man, I'm panicking right now because I have to make a million model light curves and I don't have enough time and I don't know what to do." So I ask him, "Do you have 10 minutes?" And he says, "Yeah, I have 10 minutes." Then I ask him, "Do you know who Batman is?" And he says, "Of course, Batman, yeah." And I said, "I don't think you know Batman." And so I told him to go over to Emacs and to search Batman into the search bar. And this is the tool he found. So Batman is a Python package for fast calculation of exoplanet transit light curves. It can calculate a million model light curves in well under 10 minutes for any limb darkening profile. And he was very appreciative that I showed him this tool. So I thought, why not share with the Twitterverse, right? So in this quick demo, we are going to highlight Batman, obviously. So we're going to go ahead and click on About. And this will show us how to install Batman, and it's a quick pip install, and you can just copy and paste that and type it into your terminal, and boom, you got it. So as you can see, they also have this quick start and this tutorial option, and I'm going to go ahead and take you guys through the quick start and a little bit of the tutorial. So here, this is my notebook. Everything you're seeing here is literally from this page. So, first thing you need to do is obviously you got to import all the packages you need. So we have Batman, NumPy as MP, popular, Matplotlib as PLT, also popular. And I wanted to show you guys a very, very, very basic example of how to work this tool. So what you're going to do is you are going to create this transit params object. So I just typed in params equals batman.transitParams, and you are going to define all these different parameters. So you have your time of inferior conjunction, you have your orbital period, you have your planet radius, it is in stellar radii, you have your semi-major axis, orbital inclination, eccentricity, longitude, limb darkening coefficients, and the limb darkening model. And right now we are looking at the quadratic model. All we need to do, now that we have defined all of our parameters, is we are going to set a time. We're going to use this t equals np dot lin space, and this is in days. So from negative 0.05 to 0.05 with 100 steps in between. And now we're just going to go ahead and set m, which will be our model, equal to batman dot transit model params, comma t. Is that a comma? That's a comma. And we're gonna go ahead and set flux equal to light curve params. So everything, all your flux is in these parameters. Now we are gonna go down and we are going to change this from raw to code. I wanted to surprise y'all. And that looks like a transit to me. You have about a 1% dip in brightness. So that's definitely a planet. This is a fake planet that we invented, but it's a planet. Now, what if you want to do a nonlinear limb darkening model? No worries, got you right there. Again, same thing. You enter all of these parameters and you just set your limb darkening model to nonlinear. Now we're going to go ahead and go down. Same process as before. We set the time. We initialize the model. And now we can make a light curve, same as before. Or we can make multiple light curves and we can do a little bit of science. Say you want to find out what different planet radius does to your light curve. Well, we went ahead, I say we, the creators of Batman in their tutorial, they went ahead and showed us how to do this. So all you do is you set your radii equal to this np dot lin space. So you're saying, I want my radii to be from 0.09 to 0.11 stellar radius over 5 steps, 5 iterations. So you just make this quick loop. You go ahead and redefine your planet radius, and then you plot. Oops, forgot to hit that. Okay, then you plot. And this is what you have here. So this is your nonlinear limb darkening light curve for different planet radii. This blue line corresponds to a radius of about 0.09. Meanwhile, this purple line corresponds to a radius of about 0.11. So as you can see, as we would expect, the smaller the planet, the less of a shadow it produces as it's transiting its star, resulting in this smaller dip in it, in the flux of the light curve. Pretty cool, right? So now if you're asking yourself, well, what if I need to do more than just non-linear and quadratic limb darkening? Well, they got you covered. They have all these options for your limb darkening model parameter. They have uniform, linear, quadratic, square root, logarithmic, exponential, power 2, and non-linear. Now you're asking yourself, well, what's the difference, right? What do they look like? Well, I'll show you what they look like. Again, we're going to go ahead and change this. I hope it doesn't break this time. Cool, it didn't break because I actually hit define all those parameters. So as you can see, this is what each different, or not each as in all of them, but this is what these four different models, this uniform, linear, quadratic, and nonlinear, this is how they affect your light curve. And that's basically it for this tutorial. Batman is an extremely useful tool for, you know, the best astronomers in the world all the way to, you know, freshman undergrads at whatever university. Super useful, super fast. As you can see, it's extremely simple. Well, the package itself, I'm sure, took, you know, however long to create, but they simplified it so much that, I mean, really anybody can go ahead and transit. Anybody can go ahead and produce light curves now. So that's Batman. Make sure to check it out on EMAC and make sure to follow us on Twitter at Exoplanet Models and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Bye-bye.